To our next keynote speaker, Mr. Vinod Aggarwal, MD and CEO, Volvo Eicher CV Limited, which is a joint venture company between AB Volvo of Sweden and Eicher Motors Limited. He will speak on how CV consumers are adopting innovations in the CV space. With more than 34 years of experience, Mr. Aggarwal joined Eicher in the year 1983 and has since handled various assignments in the tractor, trucks, buses, gears, and engine businesses to take over as managing director of VECV in 2016. Under his able guidance and strong leadership, VECV has grown to become one of the most formidable players in the CV segment, equipped with a strong product portfolio and cutting-edge technology. Mr. Aggarwal was conferred the CV Man of the Year Award at the annual Apollo CV Awards 2014, felicitated with the Hall of Fame Award at the 4th Annual Manufacturing Today Excellence Summit and Awards 2015, and awarded the Best CEO in the Medium and Heavy CV Makers category in 2016 by World Auto Forum. So I welcome Mr. Aggarwal on stage. Please welcome him with a big round of applause.
Very good afternoon, and thank you very much for a very liberal introduction. I don't think I deserve all that. I know we are already running late, so I'll try to save some time. And it's very, very important topic that how the consumers are adopting to innovations, you know, in the industry. And of course, I prepared some slides. I'll give you some update on the how the CV industry is evolving, and of course, how we are doing. I'll you know, back it up with some of the examples on innovation from our company, so that you know you can understand the perspective, or you can understand more. That's how you will see more examples coming from the company. So, first of all, I think the CV industry is evolving a lot. If you look at the, you know, how the trucks, if you look at the status of trucks on the roads, and if you would have noticed, the technology of the trucks even today, it's very, very low. And if you go back 5-7 years, then of course, it was much, much lower. And you would have seen that the big trucks carrying a lot of loads, they used to crawl on the roads, and the speeds were very low. They are powered by very, very low horsepower engines. But of late, the CV industry is evolving. A lot of changes are taking place, and this evolving is happening because a lot of discontinuities have happened over the past few years. For example, the road infrastructure has improved. When the road infrastructure improves, then of course you need more speed, you know, need more safety. Then there are more regulations on emission standards, so you need better engines, you need you know, trucks with cabins. So so that's the next slide. Basically, lot of shift is happening in the industry, and if you look at if earlier the consumers were looking at the lowest cost options, like acquisition cost, they used to focus a lot on that the truck should be low cost, and that's why they were going in for low technology trucks. And now, of course, the more focus is on the overall cost of ownership, that if you are running a truck for, say, 5 years or 7 years, what is the overall cost of ownership for over this period of 5 years? And then, of course, then what matters? That matters is the what is the fuel efficiency, what is the productivity, but in the uptime. So all those things matter. And then the if you analyze the entire cost of ownership, then you would see that the initial acquisition cost will be only around 20-25% of the overall cost of ownership, whereas the fuel economy or fuel cost, that will be almost 45-50%. So this change is happening, that from lowest cost to maximum productivity. A lot of innovations are happening to do that. And then of course, if earlier it was reactive management, now a lot more is the proactive management. If earlier, you know, all the transporters, they used to just go to the workshops when the trucks, you know, break down. Now, of course, there is a lot of proactive management. They will take AMCs, they will do a lot of servicing on time. So they will do a lot of things on time, from reactive to proactive, so that they can get the maximum productivity from these trucks. And then, of course, environment friendly. If earlier people were environment indifferent, now there is a lot of realization is coming. Then the government is also enforcing that, like emission norms. For example, Bharat Stage 6 emission norms, which are equivalent to Euro 6 emission norms, they are going to come from 1/4/2020. Already Euro 4 norms were, BS 4 norms were implemented from 1/4/2017. So basically, in just 3 years' time, the India is going to move from BS 4 to BS 6. And then, of course, electromobility is going to come, or a lot of other, green revolution which is happening. So a lot of things will happen. So a lot of changes are happening as far as the environment is concerned. So basically, from our organization, which is the joint venture Volvo Eicher Commercial Vehicles, we are taking the lead in meeting these expectations of the consumers, or helping them in evolving. And then, of course, we are driving innovation in everything that we are doing, from the next generation trucks to the intuitive sport solutions that we are offering to the customers. Then, of course, it starts with the, innovating in a frugal manner. Like, we have the option, since we are a joint venture with Volvo, we had the option that we could have just picked up the technology from there and put it into trucks here. But that won't work. So we have to do it in a very, very relevant manner. The first point is it has to be relevant modernization, which will need the customer needs. What does it mean? For example, if we have to improve the engine. We have the choice of just picking up the engine and putting up here. But then we have to put it, we have to develop the engine at the right cost. So there you have to pick up the right FIP system here, you have to pick up the right turbocharger, you have to, indigenize it in a proper manner, so that you work on a target costing, that you give the right cost to the customers. So again, doing a lot of innovation in the R&D, so that you are able to give the products at the right cost with the right modernization, relevant modernization, which is good for India. And then, of course, a lot of collaborative approach has to be followed with the suppliers to do this. So you have to work with all your business partners, not only the suppliers, but also with the dealers and with all other business partners. And then, of course, you have to give the whatever you do here. For example, if some job has to be done in Volvo system or in overseas, the cost, first of all, the cost of manpower is very high, and then the development costs are very high. But when you do it in India, you can do that at maybe around 1/3 of or 1/4 of the cost at which the same thing is done in overseas. Now, that is possible because in India, you get, first of all, the entry level cost of engineers is much lower than the cost of engineers there. And then in India, our executives, they are used to multitasking approach, whereas if you go to Europe, people will do one project at a time. So by doing such things, then you are able to reduce the overall cost. Again, this will help you to give the your products at the right cost. And then, of course, you have to adopt the technology in the frugal manner. And then, of course, cost benefit analysis, that whatever you can manufacture in-house or whatever you can do it outside. So based on that, you adopt the right level of in-house versus outsourcing, so that the overall costs can be minimum. Then as I mentioned, that we will give some examples from our company. We have done a lot of innovative things. Like, for example, when we started this, got into this business in 1986, it was only with one model. It was just 6-ton truck. And after that, we have now given the widest range of trucks to the customers. Like, now they have the choice, right from 6-ton up to 49-ton, at each tonnage level. Like, for example, from 5 to 15 ton range, now there are 12 various variants which are available, not only at the tonnage level, but at the body sizes. So if the customer needs, say, 10 feet body, he will get the 10 feet cargo body. If a customer needs 24 feet body, he can get 24 feet. If a customer needs 12 feet, 14 feet, so there are various types of body designs which have been done to cater to the customer requirements exactly, you know, as per his need. Similarly, for the ready mix concrete, we were the first one to offer the engine driven PTO, and we were the first to offer tiltable cabin, so that, you know, the servicing can be done very faster, it can be easier, engine can be approached very easily. Because earlier, before the tilt cabins were offered in the industry, it was very difficult to service the engines. And then, of course, now in the heavy duty trucks, our trucks are driven by 4-cylinder engine, which is again the state of the art engine. Earlier, heavy duty trucks were driven only by 6-cylinder engines. And then, of course, we were the first one to introduce 8x2 trucks in CV industry in 31 ton segment. If you look at the school buses, again, safety is very, very high focus. So we were the first company to work along with the Institute of Road Traffic Education. And we were able to develop a safest bus for the school children, which had a lot of safety features. For example, the seat belts, or the lower entry step, or if we have to, you know, the side railings on the windows. So a lot of things were done to give the safe bus to the schools. Now this is, again, as you have, you know, in the earlier presentations, you have heard of the connectivity and electromobility. And now this is, again, the finest example of, again, innovations that telematics solutions have to be provided on the products. And the telematic solution that we are providing in our trucks and buses, this is absolutely based on the latest technology, again adopted as per the Indian requirements. So this helps us not only in the fuel management, but also in the trip management as well as the uptime management. For example, you know, once you start using this telematics, sitting at the at his office, the transporter principals, they can look at the fuel efficiency of each trip. Fuel efficiency is driver by driver, or they will get the updates on the any you know, service requirements of the truck, or trip management, like the how much time the driver is taking. If driver is trying to pilfer the fuel, that report will come, or if the driver has stopped somewhere, all those reports. So basically it's very, very advanced system which can improve the productivity of the trucks, again helping the consumers with all these latest technologies. Then basically right now, as I mentioned earlier, it is the cost of ownership. So when the cost of ownership comes, then it is not only the truck, it is the after sales. I think after sales is becoming a lot more important, and the relationship with the customer has to be throughout the lifetime. So this is how all the companies in the CV sector or in the automobile sector right now working. That the once you sell a, you know, your product to a customer, that is the start of the relationship. End of the day, he has to remain with you throughout the lifetime. Now, how do you do that? Then, of course, you have to create various types of you know, products for him. For example, we have to give him on-site support. Suppose there is a cluster of trucks working in a particular place, you can set up specific workshop for him, or you have to give him the annual maintenance contract, or you have to give him the all insurance services, or you have to give him the financing services, or you have to give him the on-road full services 24/7. So various types of services you have to provide, so that the customer, after 5 years of using the truck, he comes back to you for repurchase of the truck. So that is how, you know, the entire system is working now. This is another very, very innovative solution which is there to improve the fuel efficiency. Like, we have started offering this this feature in our trucks. Now, but this feature says that there are three modes of driving a truck. It's power mode, eco mode, or eco plus mode. When the truck is driven with full load, then it can be driven at a power mode, so that the fuel consumption will be then as per the power mode. But if this full truck is loaded only 50%, then it can be driven in the eco mode, so that the fuel consumption can be less. The other thing was, even in the lot of innovation is happening that how do you improve the, again, productivity in loading? For example, as I was giving an example of the that how different sizes of bodies can be given. Now the body's design also can be done in such a manner that you can load more goods. For example, there is an example which is slightly not there, that if a truck is body is designed to carry say 5,700 trays of eggs, so you can load 171,000 eggs in one body. So you have to innovate that how do you create more space to load more trays so that you can load more eggs. Or if you are carrying the birds or the poultry chicken, then how do you provide more cages in the body so that the customer can carry more birds in the truck. So this is how you are thinking solutions with respect to the keeping the customer in mind so that he gets the maximum from the truck. Again, this is another example of very high innovation that we have done in VECV. We are now supplying Euro 6 engines to Volvo Group already. We are manufacturing Euro 6 engines in our factory in Pithampur. And these engines are fitted in all the Volvo trucks, medium-duty trucks that are sold in Europe and other countries, like in South America or even in other Asian countries or in Brazil. So this state-of-the-art plant was set up in India at, you can say, one-fourth of the cost at which Volvo Group would have set up otherwise in Europe or any other location. Now, how did we reduce this cost? We did a lot of, for example, if earlier they were using Grob machining centers, which costs very high. Now, all those machining centers we could develop here in India at a very, very low cost, at almost one-fourth of the cost. Or similarly, if the auto-guided vehicles, which they were earlier buying from Euromint, and they were buying at, say, 6.5 million rupees, we could develop it here in India at 1.6 million rupees, giving the same productivity. So based on that, the cost of plant that we have set up here, it is one-fourth. So, and then, of course, productivity-wise also, then we did a lot of innovative things. Like, for example, we used the smart cell technology for assembling of bulbs on the cylinder head. Now that, 168 parts are assembled in 130 seconds. So what happens? It reduces the, all chances of error, the productivity is maximum, and then, of course, you can absolutely, the quality levels can be the highest. So based on this, we are the exclusive manufacturing hub for the Volvo Group and for these medium-duty engines. And then, of course, 5 and 8 liter of engines are produced there. And then, of course, the capacity can be 100,000 engines. So basically, the biggest shift in the CV is beyond technology or infrastructure. It is partnering prosperity for all the stakeholders. And then, of course, from the business transaction to the lifetime relationship, which I already mentioned in my earlier slide. And here I would like to play this small video. This is just 30 seconds. Can we play that? Like, for example, the lot of focus is now coming on the drivers. The drivers have been the neglected, absolutely they are the outcast. So this is just a focus on them, that how we are bringing more focus on drivers.
अरे बलराम, तेरा ट्रक सर ने बीजू के हाथ खेड़ेगांव भिजवा दिया है।
सर,
बोलो।
आपने मेरा ट्रक बीजू को दे दी?
दे दिया।
सर, मुझसे कोई गलती हो गई है क्या?
यार, तुम ऐसे काम क्यों करते हो?
बेटे का बर्थडे ट्रक में नहीं, घर में मनाते हैं।
जी सर।
जाओ घर जाओ। अरे सुनो, कल मेरे लिए केक लाना, तभी गाड़ी दूंगा।
बिजनेस तभी बढ़ेगा जब सोच बदलेगी। आइशर एचडी प्रोसेस, नया समय नई सोच।
so this is what we are trying to do, so that you know, drivers are the most you know, neglected community, and we have to improve their lot. So that's what we are trying to do that. And with that, I end my presentation. Thank you very much. And if there are any questions, I can take. Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. Thanks for the wonderful presentation, sir. So I think a lot of points here for the people to really know, you know, there is technology and the kind of, you know, savings which is happening for India, and the manufacturing is happening in India and not across, you know, other countries. So my, you know, question is that how, you know, this particular, you know, saving is happening, as you have mentioned, 1/4 of the cost and 1/3 of the cost. Is there any analysis or analytics being used for the engines manufacturing which is being exported, and also for the factory, you know, how exactly this optimization is being done?
No, as I mentioned, for example, I gave the example of Grob machines, machining center. There are huge machining centers. Now, if we had bought those machining centers from Grob, because that was the recommended technology for that sort of machining, that would have costed around 10 crores per machine. And we could do that in India with just 2.5 crores or 3 crores. We did that, you know, with the same design. We did that entire fabrication here, and we could do that. Similarly, we did a lot of designing here. And then, of course, we could get it manufactured in China, like this entire smart cell technology that was done in China. Or I gave you the example of AGVs that we did, you know, against 6.5 million rupees, which was the clear recommendation that we should only use those AGVs. We could do it in India with just 1.5 million rupees per AGV. So like that, you know, a lot of innovative things were done so that we can reduce the initial cost of the project. And we could set up this project with around 400 crores or 500 crores, whereas if it had been set up there in any other country, it would have been around 1500 to 2000 crores. So that is how we could reduce the cost of that project. And then, of course, the quality standards and everything is same. And today, Volvo Group is getting absolutely with zero PPM engines from here. And these engines are running successfully in 43 countries, in fact, in the Volvo trucks. And the same engines now we have adopted for our heavy-duty trucks, and we are using this in India. So it's a finest example of make in India, and also the finest example of that we can do quality work in India.
Thank you.